The market where, after a rout in global markets last week, the mood has definitely turned positive. The All Ords and the ASX 200 ended the day over 1% higher. And the Aussie dollar is now buying 71.45 US. For more, I spoke with Fiona Clark from Prime Value. Fiona, a second day of gains today, and the banks and CSL in particular enjoyed a good session.
Yeah, so that's 2 days on the trot now. Yes, and CSL, major reason for today's gain, up significantly, 2% to $193. And that's partly a result of its AGM today, where guidance was reaffirmed for revenue growth of 9% and earnings net earnings growth of 10 to 14%. So a bit of a relief rally in CSL, and the banks, of course, stronger today, did a bit of the heavy lifting.
CSL just cannot put a foot wrong. This time last week, all the talk was of a crash, and now the focus is on a great US reporting season.
Well, two rises, there's some saying about summers and swallows, etc. And the same is true of the market, but I am a little bit more confident that that these 2 days do signify something more significant, and that's because they've been driven by some improved sentiment in the US, which has been driven by earnings. So we're seeing the US quarterly reporting season get underway, and some strong results from some of the first reporters that we've seen. Last night, Morgan Stanley particularly did well, and Netflix, which reported after hours, shares were up about over 10%. At one point.
Because there were concerns in particular about tech stocks and the likes of Netflix last week.
Absolutely. So the tech stocks had come under pressure, and there was concerns that they had reached a stage where they could no longer grow, that the momentum in earnings growth would slow. There was also pressure that some of the issues affecting the US in terms of whether it be tariffs or rising bond yields would have an impact on earnings. So what we're seeing is that so far so good, results have come in line with expectations or even better. So that is a good thing for our market as well.
Bad thing for our market, payday lenders are set to face a Senate inquiry. And after this news broke, we saw the likes of Afterpay shares got absolutely smashed.
Yes, so this is news not totally unexpected, that there would be a Senate inquiry into the operations of payday lenders considered to be sort of debt vultures. Now, Afterpay itself is not a payday lender. It actually doesn't fall under the normal laws of consumer credit because it doesn't charge interest. It charges a late fee. But the interpretation of this news is that it may be form part of the inquiry, and certainly that it will be under the spotlight. Credit Corp, which actually does have a consumer finance business, also came under pressure today, and its shares were down 9% as well. So very interesting move there. A lot of froth taken off the Afterpay share price.
Fiona Clark, thanks so much.